It's very good afternoon to all of you. Esteemed guest, chairperson, Professor Padhi, and other speaker, eminent delegates, and my dear students. I'm not from the Department of Journalism and Mass Communication. I'm from a very newly created department, which is Good Governance and Public Policy. So since morning, I'm hearing that so governance is only for the public organizations. I may be wrong, I don't want to point out any eminent speaker for their sharing of their information or any view, but governance is not all about the running of institutions at the government level. I hope all of you agree. It is a decision-making process for both government as well as private organizations. And when we are running a democratic governance in a country like India, definitely we need public opinion. Because a layman point of view, democracy is, can you say? What do you mean by democracy? Yes. And as per Lincoln's view, Abraham Lincoln's view, of the people, by the people, and for the people. And the governance is also in a democratic setup for the people, and also by the people, and also it is run by the people. And when it is for the people, definitely we need public opinion. And I'll take 5 to 10 minutes of time, not much more than that, just to highlight why PR is necessary. From what background, from what situation, that particular concept, public relation, comes out. And what are the different approaches or developmental stages of PR in India? In a very nutshell, with 4 points. Then, coming to the current status of PR in India, from government to private organizations, how do they handle PR? How do they need PR? And what is the role of PR in different setup? And it is not at all a very new concept. It is as old as the civilization, human civilization. If you go through the background of public relation, definitely the ancient clay tablet which was found in Iraq told the Sumerian farmers how to grow better crops. You can, like a new generation, you can just link with your, after the session also, you can go and find out all these things through different sources at internet. And this case was over 4,000 years old. The next example is Arabian Tales. The Arabian Tales relate how Sultan Harun at Rashid used to wonder about every night to see himself as an administrator and what people really felt about his administration. Just to get that information about people's perception regarding his administration. Then coming to India, from Ramayana, there is a character, Bhadra. How many of you know about Bhadra? Anybody? What is the role of the character Bhadra in Ramayana? Anyone, please? This is our great, like, mythological story. Let me say, the role or the character of Bhadra used to report Rama about his decision making process and the perception of local people or public regarding his administration. Just to get the information, and right now from the current modern technology or modern words, we used to take it as feedback system. Okay. Then from that mythological public relations, India's pride and treasure, two great epics, that is Ramayana and Mahabharata, the first peer in the whole peer industry, the role of Narad, sharing information, collecting information, and also exchanging information, then branding some specific person. And but the motive was for the peace or universal peace of the society, not for personal benefit. Then Gautam Buddha, Shankaracharya, Nanak, Kabir were the master communicator to share their views, which is for universal peace, not for individual benefit, not for individual any personified benefit to get. And just clubbing Mughal rule administration in India and British's administration, their way of collecting information from the society, from the public, getting opinion about that administration was different. But the first newspaper also published in 1780s in India, just to share information with the public to brand their administration. And coming to our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi, initiating freedom movement, the pre-independence period and the post-independence period. The branding of freedom movement, and also inviting people for their opinion to join that freedom movement. If it is so, during First World War, in 1914 to 1918, that particular period, the government of India has set up Central Publicity Board, because we need to understand first the government setup, no? Then only you can compare with the government organizations and the private organizations and the whole governance system. That Central Publicity Board, renamed as Central Bureau of Information, then Bureau of Public Information, just to link government with press. And J. Natarajan, the pioneer, Lucknow, was appointed as Deputy Principal Information Officer. The Bureau in 1938. It was established in 1938. Just post-independence period, in 1947, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting was set up by Government of India, as well as at different central state government. The role is to link with the public, and also how to influence public sharing information of the government decisions. Coming to the private sector, Tata Company, or the Tata's group, has set up a public relations department in Mumbai in 1943, headed by Sri Vino Mashani. And at the public sector enterprise level, the department, they have their administrative and corporate relations department, just to have a relationship with the government as well as the public. And recently, in private sector as well as in government sector, they have CSR department or public relationship department, just to run the CSR project. And it is meant to get good image in front of the public. There are four stages of PR or public relation in India. First one is philanthropic approach. That philanthropic approach, during that First World War or just during the Second World War, out of necessity to get public opinion, to get public relationship, and also to share good image of the government with the public. The second one, conscious public relations approach. The next phase, the second approach, was more serious than the first approach. And the first approach, when it was philanthropic approach, in 1912, Tata's building Jamshedpur as model township. See, pre-independence period, philanthropic approach and public relations. At the government level, railways, by the government of India, the railway department initiated to provide considerable cost for the public as well as other facilities. That is also meant for the public relation. Second phase, that conscious approach of public relation, because of certain specific objective or factors. One is public opinion, mass circulated newspaper by different media house, influential press during that time, and also need for mobilizing public opinion in favor of the war effort, the Second World War time I'm talking about. The Indian National Congress against that particular war effort, Ministry of Information was set up just to get and share this war effort with the public and create a positive public opinion. And Tata's, they set up PR department in those days, in 1943. Coming to the third approach of PR, that is responsible organization approach and responsible approach towards the organizations by making the post-independence era in India. Establishing parliament, legislatures at the state level, and also sharing of information with the public to get a good public image. Whatever policy they are deciding at the parliament level, at the legislature level, they used to share those things with the public. That was the intention during those days. The new environment, the new policies, new economical status of India just post-independence period, emergence of industrial policy, emergence of industrial act to develop industrial or economical industry to increase the economical status of the nation, then that was the situation, totally new environment where the government of India tried a lot to get public opinion. And in private sector, deliberate policies are made by the government as well as in private sector in modern sense. How to create and share a good public image through PR or professional peers. The last approach of public relation in India is professional approach of public relation. That is, organization established, professional organizations, peer organizations established in Mumbai and Calcutta in 1958. Tata Steel organized a peer course in 1960s. First peer conference in April 1968, and to bring good image and public opinion strategically. That was the situation, post-independence situation in India. Then, just going through these background and the approach of the government from earliest period, pre-independence period, and post-independence period. Then what is PR is all about? Why it is necessary for public as well as private organizations. Why it is necessary for government as well as private sectors? PR is the art and science of managing communication between an organization and the key constituents to build, manage and sustain its positive image. And the CSR part is nothing but it is just initiative by the government to make it compulsory for the public organizations as their social obligation for good relationship between public and private and the public opinion. As per business standard, it is nothing but branding of a government organization or a public organization or a private company or a specific person. But if we refer the code of conduct, it is not bad, not good, but it is necessary in every sphere as a professional peer, whether they are working in public or private sector. As per business standard, 2nd June 2012 on understanding the peer industry in India, coming to Wipro, they asked for their peer professionals how best to communicate their messages and present them in a context that is meaningful for clients, analysts, investors and journalists, so that they will have a good public image as compared to their competitors also. And here the social media is playing a greater role for publicity and to get also public opinion. Catching up first with, like, as compared to the traditional media. Coming to FMCG company, which is faster than other products, they prefer advertising plus PR, not only advertisement. Nowadays, in the, like, the VUCA world, the FMCG company, they want advertising plus PR. Minu Handa, Microsoft Director Communication, believes that PR will be recognized as a strategic tool for two reasons. One is impulsion of digital and social media, two-way engagement. And second is imperative need for organizations, including government, business, NGOs, to be extremely transparent. And we have already discussed about the transparency as a major tool among the features of good governance. That concept, employer branding or branding of any organization, branding of any owner, that concept has come out in 90s, just before the new economic policy 1991. And as image, the great place to work. And I hope you have also that idea. We are also comparing in IT sector, this is the best place to work and this is not. And this culture is best, and this culture is better than that particular company. That is because of public opinion and the good image or the image of any company in front of others. So branding, great place to work in the mind of current employees, key stakeholders, clients and customers. Coming to, in reference to the reputation today on India's biggest PR firms. In India, it is a concept during last two decades, and based upon the revenue size above 100 crore, Ad Factor is a company, it is a consultancy created by Rajesh Chaturvedi, and it has crossed 125 crore in 2016, which was created in 1980s, and they are more than 100 crores. Their revenue size is very high as compared to any other consultancy. And they are into PR and corporate communication. So globally, In India, if we analyze the public relation, public opinion, and in democracy, how important is this, then definitely we need to get that statistics. Maybe the parameters are different from one survey to other survey, but you need to get that statistics, how they are different from others, and how many peer consultancy, peer professionals, their reputation is very high in terms of the public opinion and mass or communication, public communication. In governance, the role of public relation, whether of a ministry or a department, is most important. And nowadays, through CSR Act, it is mandated for the companies established under Government Companies Act to go abide by those CSR rules. For private sector, it is up to them. It based upon the revenue size as well as the business. So with this, I hope I took the minimum time just to place the background of PR and why it is necessary, what are the different approaches, as well as it is not important for private organization, it is also important for the government professionals and non-profit organizations. Now, the coming generation, they will go by whether they need to go with some code of conduct, ethical standards, or there are certain rules and regulations. But definitely, PR is necessary at each and every level for public opinion and also the branding of government and public government and private organizations. Thank you. Thank you for like invitation by Professor Padi, as well as thank you for your patience for the post-lunch plenary session. Thank you so much.